You're a little late tonight, huh? Had a big birthday party? Did you have a lot of fun? Get a lot of presents? 6 years old and you got a lot of presents. Well, I brought one for you. Hurt.
You did, Barnaby?
Yeah, I brought one. Remember the other night you were dreaming and we were talking about it and you said, wouldn't it be nice if I could save all the dreams that I have dreamed and have them all in one night. Just one beautiful night of your bestest dream. Remember that? When you said that? Well, I said, why shouldn't I do it for my friend Hurt? I've got a very special one just for you. You know where I'm keeping it? Inside a Hercules bone. In your imagination. Oh, imagination is a wonderful place. It's a great big place with a lot of pockets and corners and drawers and things of that sort. All full of wonderful things and all the great dreams that we've had. It's about time that we got going, don't you? Come on. Let's get going. Come on down. Attaboy. You'll see some people and things you haven't dreamed about a long time. Like that fella. Remember him? Sure you do. He's that old bully frog who likes to take advantage of everyone who's smaller than he is. Oh, I wish there was some way that we could warn that little worm. That old bully frog. It just goes to show you that first impressions can be kind of deceiving, right?
Right.
Well, I hope that he'll think twice before he tackles some little old worm. Say, I've got something here for you. It's just a plain piece of cloth, right?
Right.
Now we take one end and we put it over here. We have to straighten it out first. Take one end, we're going to put it over here in between my fingers and pull it up tight. Take the other end and pull it up tight over here. And what have we got?
A rabbit.
A rabbit, yeah. Hello, rabbit.
Hello.
How are you?
Okay.
Say, that's kind of a magic rabbit. Tell me, rabbit, who's the silliest looking person in the whole dream?
You are.
I'll ask it again. Who?
You are.
Well, I guess I better ask it something else. Tell me, where do you think we ought to go now?
Where do you want to go?
To the park. Yeah, that's right. To the park.
Barnaby, the park in the middle of the night?
Oh, sure, Herc. In a dream, you can make the middle of the night seem as bright and sunny as the middle of the day. That's one of the things that's so very special about a dream. Oh, look. Look at all those bubbles.
They sure are pretty, aren't they?
Yeah, I'll say.
I hope one of them lands on the wall here.
Why?
Well, I want to give one of the bubbles to my cousin Wilhelmina. Yeah, she loves pretty things.
Hey, wait a minute. You can't give her a bubble, for heaven's sakes.
Why not? She'd love it. Oh, look. Hey, well, one landed on the wall there.
Well, what do you think you're going to do with it?
Well, put it in the box, of course. You're going to pick up that bubble and put it in the box? Why not?
This I've got to see.
Here, take that.
Thought, but I don't believe.
Why not?
You can't pick up a bubble.
That was impossible. Jeffrey, you're always saying something can't be done until somebody else comes along and does it. You should be very careful about saying something can't be done.
I'll watch it in the future.
Boy, look at all those ducks. There must be 100 of them.
Yeah, they're migrating, I guess. Oh, by the way, don't mention ducks around Magnolia.
Yeah, sure, okay. Don't mention ducks around Magnolia? Why?
Well, they make her sad because she can't fly.
Oh, I see. No, I don't see. Why should they make her sad?
Because she can't fly. Don't you understand? Magnolia's a bird, and birds are supposed to fly. But, well, she's an ostrich bird, and ostriches can't fly. So when she sees the ducks flying south for the winter or north for the summer, well, she'd like to fly off with them, but she can't.
But she's known that all her life. I mean, you know, I...
Look out. Here she comes. Don't talk.
Yeah. Well, hi, Magnolia.
Yes, Magnolia. How are you feeling, huh?
Oh, I'm a little better, thank you. I think my ankle will be well enough for me to try to fly off the wall again this afternoon.
Now, that's silly, and you know it. You shouldn't have tried to fly off this wall in the first place. You'll break your neck, Magnolia. Look at those silly ducks. Quiet down there!
You know, they think they own this place. I'm going to give them a piece of my mind if they land on the lake. I'll tell you that. Excuse me. Now, listen, Magnolia. You shouldn't envy the talents of others. Sure, ducks can fly. But you can do lots of things that ducks can't do.
Oh, but what good is a common, old, ordinary, everyday ostrich?
What good is an ostrich? Are you kidding? Why, Well, people use ostrich feathers to decorate their hats and dresses and things.
Yes, but what can an ostrich do?
What can an ostrich do, she asks. Well, that's easy. An ostrich can... an ostrich is the only bird... an ostrich can,
See what I mean. Yeah. Happy little bluebirds fly beyond the rainbow, why can't I?
Hey, Albert, I'm back.
Yeah, hey, yourself, what happened? You took one look in my animal book and ran off.
I found the answer to Magnolia's problem.
Yeah.
Oh, there she goes again.
Yeah, what is this? She's been running back and forth like mad for the past half hour.
Well, I told you, she just needed to understand that we are all good for something. So I made her read the part in your animal book that says the ostrich is the fastest running bird in the whole world. They can run as fast as 50 or 60 miles an hour. In fact, a full-grown ostrich can outrun a fast horse.
No kidding.
Yeah, it's a fact, my little chipmunk friend. You can read it yourself. Oh, hi, Magnolia.
Oh, Albert, I just wanted you to know that if you have any errands to run, I'll be just glad to do them for you.
Really?
You too, Sir Jeffrey.
Yeah.
I've started an express messenger service,
uh-huh.
And the rates are very low. Being an ostrich, I just love to run.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, boy. See that? Did you see that? Now that she has faith in herself, why, she's happy again. What's the matter with you?
Oh, nothing.
Come on, what's the matter?
Well, it's just that, I was just thinking, what good is a common old, ordinary, everyday chipmunk like me?
Oh, no.
You're not a common old, ordinary, everyday chipmunk, Albert.
Of course not. But he'll have to prove that to himself, you see, like Magnolia had to do. Maybe she'll have to find it out in a book like Jeffrey the Giraffe did.
I've lots of books in here, but I can't read them very well.
Well, you'll learn to read and to write and to add, and learning is a way of becoming somebody.
I want to become somebody else. I just want to become myself.
That's what I mean. You'll be yourself. You see, learning will make Hercules Brown a better Hercules Brown.
I make the rain fall up instead of falling down.
The rain fall up instead of falling down? Well, I don't think so, but I'd be the first one to encourage you to try. Like Albert the Chipmunk said, people are always saying something can't be done, and then somebody comes along and does it. Why, every day people are doing the impossible.
Di-di-di-di-di, di-dum-dum. Oh, what a beautiful day it is today. Isn't it a beautiful day? I love days like today because they're so beautiful. I just enjoy loving a beautiful day. And I enjoy enjoying it, too. Di-di-di-di-di.
Snarf, rats, corundridge.
Nice things about rainy days, too. The rain feels very refreshing. My. Isn't this nice?
Snarf, Grenif, Graf Snake. Shuff, laugh.
After all, rain brings the pretty flowers. Like this one over here. Everything about this flower is pretty. The petals are pretty. And the leaves are pretty. And it smells pretty. It's just pretty all over. The flower pot is pretty, too.
Grinch, Grinch, Grinch.
But you don't have to have something to look at to enjoy it. Just listen. Listen to that bird singing. Say, you're not very nice. In fact, you're perfectly awful.
You're flankery mawaf.
You're so perfectly awful that it's beautiful.
Kavois?
I'm sure that you've tried all your life to be perfectly awful, working and working year after year just to be as bad as possible. And now all your toil and self-sacrifice has made you a success. You set yourself a goal and you have succeeded.
Kaboomoo.
Perfection is a beautiful goal to strive for. You should be congratulated.
Murgy free, Vova, free?
Yes, you're so awful, it is truly beautiful. You're a perfect example of beautiful awfulness.
We're personally awful, Snoop.
You gotta talk your troubles down to a size where you can handle them.
So long, Sue. Come back in another dream.
What are strings on your fingers for, Barnaby?
Well, I put the strings on my fingers to...
I try to help you remember, Barnaby?
No, it's my responsibility. That's it. Responsibility. I wanted to talk to you about responsibility.
I know it's your responsibility to get me in before wake-up time.
That's a good example of my responsibility. But you see, we both have responsibilities. Like, well, obeying the law. And coming to the aid of a friend who is in need. And being kind to animals.
Hear, hear. I'll vote for that. Well, hear, hear.
Hello, who are you?
Hello there. Well, my name is Ralph.
Well, hello, Ralph. Hello. This is Hercules.
Hello, Hercules.
And my name is Barnaby.
Hello, Barnaby.
May I ask you a question, please?
Oh, well, certainly.
Are you a dog?
Well, let's see. I got a fuzzy face, and I got long ears. I got a coal black nose, and I got a tail.
True.
So either I'm a handsome dog or a very ugly person.
This is remarkable.
How come?
I've never met a dog that talked.
Oh, sure you have. All dogs can talk.
They can?
Sure.
I have a dog named Skipper, and he can't talk.
Skipper? I was just talking to Skipper the other day. You know, we were just sitting there sharing this big bone. And all of a sudden, Skipper, he looks up at me and he says, "The existential quintessence of Euclidean logic is the cornerstone of Neo-Brechtian semantics."
Well, what does that mean?
I don't know. I just says woof, woof, and kept eating.
Well, that's interesting, but... if dogs can talk, why I haven't met more, I don't understand.
Well, you see, to tell you the truth, a dog doesn't really have much to talk about.
Oh, that's too bad.
Sure. Just think about it. What do dogs do? Well, they eat, they sleep, and chase cats. Well, and that's all.
I guess you're right.
Yes, these things are dull. Who wants to talk about eating, sleeping, and chasing cats all the time? That's dull. Dull, that's what that is.
Didn't think of that.
Yeah. Well,
why don't dogs do more interesting things?
Because we don't know how to do interesting things. You see, we've never been to school.
Why doesn't somebody start a school for dogs?
I'm glad you said that, because I am starting one.
Great.
You see, all the dogs in the world who've been spending their times eating, sleeping, and chasing cats can come to my school, and I shall teach them.
What are you going to teach them?
Eating, sleeping, and chasing cats.
Oh, Ralph.
Well, that's all I know how to teach. I'm a dog, you know.
This is getting silly.
Well, of course it's silly. What do you expect, talking to a dog?
Well, I guess he's right. What do you expect, talking to a dog? Oh, a lot of exciting things are happening tonight. Isn't that right? Are you having fun?
Sure, visiting those dreams on birthdays, lots of fun, Barnaby.
Certainly they are. And you will have to save up all your old dreams all year long so we can take another trip on your next birthday.
It's time to go home already?
Well, it's my responsibility to take you home, but how about a bedtime story?
A bedtime story in the middle of a dream?
Certainly in the middle of a dream. All you have to do is just dream about somebody who hasn't gone to bed yet, and then you listen to their bedtime story. And it's just about time for old Lamb Chop to have his bedtime story, and we're in luck. We got the best storyteller in the whole world.
Best bedtime storyteller I know is my mom.
That's what I mean.
I think I would like you to tell me a story about a little lamb.
Oh, no.
What do you mean, oh, no?
Well, I want to tell you a story about a little duck.
What? What's wrong with lambs?
Nothing is wrong with lambs.
I'm glad to hear that.
Well, it's just that lambs are different from ducks.
What do you mean we're different.
Well, don't take it easy. Everybody's different. That's no calamity. That's fine. It's just I can't tell my duck story about a lamb.
Why not?
Because lambs don't come out of eggs.
Oh, that's true.
Yes, that's true.
Do elephants come out of eggs?
Nope.
What do elephants come out of?
I think elephants come out of trunks.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
What does come out of eggs?
Oh, sometimes the most surprising things.
Like what?
Like, I got a story.
Like, I want to hear it.
Like, once upon a time, in a barnyard.
Excuse me, I didn't mean to interrupt, but where was the barnyard?
Oh, it was away somewhere.
Oh, there.
Yeah. One of the eggs that Mrs. Duck had been sitting on cracked open. And she got a tremendous surprise when out popped
an elephant!
Oh.
Elephants are tremendous.
Yes, but elephants don't come out of eggs.
Oh, yeah.
No, out popped a bundle of feathers and feet that didn't look anything like any of Mrs. Duck's other children.
Oh, you know what it was?
What?
It was a lamb. That's what it was, a lamb.
It had feathers.
It wasn't a lamb.
No. No, nobody knew what it was. And do you know what happened? What do you think happened?
I'm not very good at thinking.
Oh, okay. I will tell you what happened.
And I will listen.
That's good. There once was an ugly duckling.
A duckling?
With feathers all stubby and brown. And the other birds in so many words said, get out of town. Get out. Get out. Get out of town. And he went with a quack and a waddle and a quack. And a flurry of eiderdown.
Idaho?
What?
Who's eiderdown?
It's feathers.
She's feathers?
No, it is feathers.
What's feathers?
Eiderdown.
Idaho?
Forget it. That poor little ugly duckling wandered far and near. But the other birds in so many words said, get out of here.
Get out, out of here.
Get out, get out of here. And he went
with a quack,
and a waddle, and a quack, and a very unhappy tear.
Why was he crying?
Well, you know, all the other birds were going, get out of here.
If you do that again, I'll cry too.
All through the wintertime, he hid himself away, afraid to show his face, ashamed of what others might say. All through the winter, in his lonely clump of weed, till a flock of swans spied him there, and they very soon agreed, you're a very fine swan indeed.
A swan. Me, a swan. Go on.
Well, sure you're a swan, they said. Now just look at yourself in the lake, and you'll see. And he looked, and he saw, and he said,
it's me! I am a swan! Now who's an ugly duckling?
No feathers, all stubby or brown. For the other birds in so many words with the best in town.
I'll do it.
The best. The best. The best in town. Not a quack, not a quack, not a waddle or a quack, but a glide and a whistle.
I can't whistle.
That's all right. And a snowy white back.
And a head so noble and high.
Now an ugly duckling.
Not me.
Not me?
Not me. Oh, not
was a good bedtime story. I'm getting sleepy. Getting sleepy? Say, it's about time I got you back in bed. Come on, Hurt. Up we go. Get down in there. Now you can reminisce about all the good times that we had tonight, right? Good night, Hercules, and good day.
Tell me a dream.